I enjoyed the wonderful screen chemistry in the film between the two of you. Could you talk a little bit about how you developed the screen chemistry as actors, set in a period of oppressive social mores in America?
Sweetheart?
This is your specialty question.
Yeah, people keep asking about this. I mean, my opinion is that chemistry isn't something you can create. Very much the same way in real life. You either have chemistry with someone or you don't. You can't, I mean, a director can create it in post, but it's not something you can work on. You either have it or you don't. And I mean, I felt lucky in that it was easy for me to feel chemistry towards Cate, not only because, you know, she's Cate, but just, you know, my character spent much of the film just sort of in awe of this woman and enamored with her, and that was very easy for me to embody.
Both characters they're quite isolated. Not only because you know, their feelings for one another sort of set them apart from the worlds in which they inhabit, but you know, the gap in their ages, and you know, they go through a lot of processing these volcanic feelings independent of one another. So frankly, it was a relief to do sort of the scenes with Rooney. It's like, finally we get to, you know, be together. So it's actually, you know. I read a letter recently written by a woman in China who's in the 1400s, whose husband was a nobleman and he perished, and this letter was found with his body. He was entombed. And the passion that was in this letter about how she was pregnant with their child, I felt it was written yesterday. And there's a sense that somehow if people fall in love in the 50s because they're wearing girdles, that they don't feel the same things that we feel. And so it's about finding the timeless nature of that, the kind of the deeply human, eternal side of falling in love. And I mean, I was joking about Romeo and Juliet, but really, I mean, it's when you fall in love, it's as if no one else has experienced what you're experiencing. It's dangerous, you're out of control, it's akin to sort of panic and you know, and fear, and the your heart, that's why, you know, your heart literally beats faster. And I mean, that doesn't change whether you're wearing a corset or, you know, whether you're wearing a G-string. It's sort of probably easier to get naked, but you know, but it's finding that connection.